Kind of sucks. Yeah, they stripped a lot of things down, hoping it would do something, but that's, of course, that's a lazy approach. Because ZeniMax always does, like, the lazy things first, and I think even they know that it won't do anything. There's a couple things that they could do that would definitely fix performance, but it requires them to actually, like, pay some money, get some people involved, get some shit done, and for some reason they just don't want to do it, and I don't understand it. Like, it's been so long, this shit could have been fixed years ago. It's not like that big of a deal. It doesn't cost like a fuck ton of money. It doesn't require a fuck ton of people. It just requires a couple of them and a little bit of money. And if you could stop being so fucking greedy and just fucking trying to grab every single fucking dollar that you can get, you could just say, all right, here's the money, here's the people, fix it. You got a couple of weeks now until we have the next update. Just get it done, get it out of the way, and just we can focus on other things. You know, because the complaining is never going to stop. ZeniMax is getting really annoyed with people complaining about the performance. But I mean, you're not fixing it. Like, how are people supposed to stop complaining about something that never gets fixed? It's just, it doesn't make sense. Yeah, of course they know it's their code chillers. And it is their code. And it is most likely the net code. And it's most likely from back in the day when they reworked the netcode to prevent cheating. Because as you might remember, we had some cheat engine issues in the past, and they reworked the netcode. And they moved a lot of calculations and a lot of actions from the client side, which is better for the server, to the server side, which is worse for the server. Because now the server has to make all these calculations that the game clients used to do. It is safer because there's a lot of data that you can't influence with a cheat engine, because with the cheat engine you can basically only influence the data that's processed by your client and sent off to the server, and the server just accepts the data as it is. So you could just say, okay, I'm invincible, I have, I don't know, 10k spell damage, or my speed is higher or something like that. So you could just send that out to the server, and the server just says, okay, I'm fine with that. And, you know, they change a lot of things, and they move a lot of calculations over to the server side so that you cannot influence these values anymore. But that also means that when there's 100 people in a keep running into each other, the fucking server gets a heart attack and it can't keep up with the calculations anymore. And there's, like, these tiny fucking, like, calculations that have... that are going on all the time. When you roll dodge, you gain physical and spell resistance. Like, everybody has this in the CP campaign. So everybody who's dodging gets this. So this has to be calculated. When you begin bracing, you gain a damage shield. Not everybody has this, but a lot of people have this. So this has to be calculated all the time. When you take critical damage, you heal for a really small amount. A lot of people have this passive. So, you take critical damage, guess what? When you run into a fucking Zerg, you're gonna take massive amounts of critical damage. So, this constantly goes off for 100 people in a small area. When you bash somebody, you gain health. This is easily, like, you only need rank 10 for this. Only 10 points, so a lot of people have this. And everybody that does, like a bash cancel combo, is gonna get this. There's so many. Like, when you deal critical damage, you heal. Boom. A lot of people do a lot of critical damage. This goes off all the time. There's so many, like, teeny tiny passives in here that constantly have to be calculated in a large fight. That nobody needs. Because I don't think getting a 600 point damage shield is gonna save me from anything. Or getting a fucking 301 health heal is going to save me from anything. That's not going to change anything. You know, either put good values on, and either you just fucking, like, multiply that by like 10, and you actually make the value meaningful, and you put a fucking a fucking cooldown on it, or you just fucking strip that shit. Because who needs a fucking 300 health heal? You can't even see that fucking thing on your health bar. You can't even see your health bar move when you get 300 health. It's just stupid. It's stupid. Like, and all these little fucking passives, they go off like a hundred, like multiple hundred times every second in a fight. Why not just 300? Don't ask me, dude. Don't ask me. So, there's a lot of shit that literally doesn't benefit anyone. But it creates calculations. It's stuff that the server has to keep track of. And if you are wondering why you can't cast your skills anymore in a large battle, it's because the fucking server has fucking died calculating a fucking 600 point damage shield for 80 people. That's why. Because the fucking server can't keep up anymore. Because here's the thing. It's not just that. It's not as easy as, hey, you get 300 health for like bashing somebody. It's like, hey, okay, you get 301 points of health for doing crit damage. But you have a healing bonus that's like 20% because you're in a keep. Okay, so that's that much. And you also have major mending, so that's that much. But this guy hit you with a fucking blast bone, so you're defiled, so I have to subtract something of that again. And this guy hit you with another buff that buffs your healing by another couple percent. So it's another couple percent on top of that. And so there's like five calculations going on just to calculate the fucking 300 point heal that you get for like doing crit damage. And now just fucking multiply that by 100 for like all the fucking people inside a huge keep fight. It's no wonder the fucking server can't keep up with this shit. It's no wonder. It's just the one fucking passive. You just look at it and you just like really like think deeply what's going into this calculation. What's exactly like affecting this fucking passive? And you're like, okay, all of a sudden you can see clearly why we're having performance issues. Because the server is so fucking busy just getting shit calculations that don't fucking matter. Just get the shit out of here. Like, how long does this take? Seriously, let me into the fucking office. Show me the fucking computer. I'm gonna sit down. I'm gonna take that shit out. It takes me 15 minutes. Boom, it's fixed. How hard is it? How hard is it? Like, why is this such a big deal? Someone needs to sit down, take these shit passives out, and we're done. We're done. Like, I don't get it. Like, why does this take years to fix? Why do you try to fucking sell the PvP audience a performance fix where you rework non-combat paths? What is that going to do for PvP? What is that going to do for PvP? You can't even have pets out in PvP. It's like, stop selling me these fucking... It's just like snake oil. It doesn't do shit. It's like, oh yeah, we're going to fix this and that's it's going to fucking make your... It's going to make your fucking experience better. No, it's not. It's not. Everybody knows it. It's so stupid. Sippy, thank you so much for gifting in Kitty. Kitty, welcome in. Thank you so much. So yeah, like, I don't know. I don't know why we're like still struggling with performance. If there's a couple things that you can do right now that would immediately impact performance in a big way. It's beyond me. I can't get it into my head why they just keep like dicking around for so long. They're just pussyfooting around the actual issue. And the actual issue is the fucking amount of calculations that need to be made. Oh, holy shit. Sippy's gifting in. Oh god, what's that name? Latency Challenged. And Janaf. And Mallow. Welcome. Welcome in, guys. Thank you so much. You guys like the rants, huh? You guys like the rants. If you want more rants, just saying. If you want more rants, go watch that video. You're gonna watch me 27 minutes just ranting about vampires. So yeah. But that's like the point that I've been trying to make for like so long. Not just me, like a lot of people have talked about this. Fangrush talks a lot about this. He understands a lot about this issue. And I don't know, like how expensive could it be, and how long would it take to actually just do these little changes that just immediately impact the performance? I don't think it's going to be a huge deal. You can do this in like literally like a day. You could do this in a day. You just sit down, you take these passives out, and you're done. Or maybe put a cooldown on. Put a 5-second cooldown on. Even that would help. Because that would mean the server doesn't have to make these calculations all the time. You know, just a 5-second cooldown, maybe increase the value, make it more meaningful, and then put a cooldown on. And that alone would just do so much for the performance, but it's not being done. No one gives a shit. No one cares. Like PvPers complain about the performance because it's not being fixed. And ZeniMax is complaining about the PvPers that are complaining about the performance that they've never fixed in the first place. So yeah. It's so easy, ZeniMax. You know, it's up to you. Just fix the fucking performance and we stop complaining. If you don't like us complaining all the time, just fucking fix the issue. It's so simple. It's so simple. It's like... It doesn't even make sense that it's not fixed yet. It doesn't even make fucking sense. Ugh. Anyway. Ugh, thank you so much, Sippy. More rants, it improves performance, yeah. It improves performance because I don't have to do anything. Performance is really nice when you just stand still and do nothing. Look at the frames, dude. Woo! Look at the frame rates. Bam. That's my rant, guys. That is my rant, and that's also the end of the stream. I'm gonna peace out now. Probably gonna have another drink and then think long and hard about a new build. If you guys have any ideas for new builds, let me know. Hit me up on Twitter, hit me up on Discord, hit me up on, I don't know, wherever you can find me. Because, like, I'm running out of ideas. Like, let me rephrase that. I'm running out of ideas that are actually possible in ESO. Because I have a lot of ideas that I just can't do because I don't have the tools to do it. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, they... Absolutely true, Teen Crumpet. They fucking censor every fucking criticism that you have. If you mention anything about performance, boom, you're just getting kicked out. It's crazy. And I don't understand why you can't just fucking fix it and be done with it. And then everybody's happy. The PvPers don't complain anymore. And you as a company, you don't have to listen to people complaining anymore. You know, because people are actually going to be happy. It's just... I mean... Just get this. The amount of work required to make a new DLC is like tenfold or twentyfold of what it actually takes to fix PvP. It's not that much work. You just have to attack the right things, and you can fix performance immediately. But the money and the work required to make a new DLC is immense. Because you need a lot of artists. You need people that write the lore. You need people that create the map. You need people that write the music. You need people that write the quest lines and shit like that. And people that do artwork. Like, there's so many people involved that have to work together to make a DLC. It costs a lot of money. It takes a long time. Fixing PvP can be done in a week, tops. And it wouldn't cost nearly as much money. But it's not being done. And, like, I don't get it. I really don't understand it.